Today we will learn about this number formatting. What is basically number formatting? There are different number formattings over there. In general format, we have some general formatting, like we can type numbers, it will take as numbers. We can type text, it can take as text. We will type date, now it is custom. It has changed this number formatting. So in general, you can do general work. For specialized things, let me understand what the number formatting is. I type here some numbers. So here are few numbers, there are some negative values. So if the format is general, we don't need to do anything. We go to this format cell, is the general, we don't need to do anything. In number formatting, here you can see the sample. Whether you want to put decimal places, it will look like that. You can increase from here, decrease. You want to use thousand separator, you can click on that and it will look like this one. And this section is for your negative numbers, that how you want to show your negative numbers. By default, it is keep showing by negative sign, such as this. If you select this one, this will show your negative numbers as red. And here you have negative numbers in brackets. And here you will find negative number in brackets as well as in red. Yes, so there are different formatting options available with number formatting. When we move to currency, let we do it default. When we move to currency, it gives us flexibility to put our currency, such as we put currency here. There are a lot of symbols there. I have downloaded Indian rupees symbols in that. You can put currency through these, and such as number formatting, number category, the currency is also having negative number specification here. So you can choose by that. There is a difference in currency and accounting. Now I put some values as zeros. So here I have applied currency format, and now here I will apply accounting format. In accounting, you have symbol, sign and decimal places, but when you do it in accounting format, it will show you like this. So in currency format, it is more focused on currency, but in accounting format, our currency sign is aligned and it will denote a minus sign or dash sign as a zero. So for accounting purpose, it is mostly used, that accounting formatting. Now let's move with dates. What is the
that is only the difference for this accounting and the currency
yes
formats?
Yes.
Okay.
Now let's move to dates. First, we should know what is the proper format for putting date, because we put like that. It means 12 January 14. It is in month, date and year format, not date, month and year. So that I want to put 1st December 2014, but it will show me 12 January 2014 if I convert in date format. So first we need to know that if we are putting our date, whether it is right or wrong, is it going in proper format or not. So when I type date, I type as 1 dash this 1 and dash again and 14. I type like this. So the formation I can see in my formula bar, it is different. It means it is correct. Now in my date format, I can plus some values. I can plus minus directly. I have added 10 days here. Just doing that. Now I select date. In number format, I go to date option. There are different types of dates here. If I select this one, it will show me the day name, such as Sunday, Monday, and the month name, the date and the year, such as this. So we have different formats for showing our values differently. The most common format we like is this one. You can see lot of formats. If you want time with it, it is there. If you want only month and year, sometimes we put dates and we want month and year to be shown only. So we can just choose from format only. You don't need to type all the time. Abbreviated month name and date and year. There are a lot of options which you can use as per your requirement. That a date is still there. If you choose this, you will see the whole date, but what is there, it is a format change the visibility of the data, not change the reality of data. Now let's move to time. You have different time formats over here. Let us know about time. The proper format for putting time this one. And if it is converted like that, that means you are doing in a right way. Now I can't plus in that directly, but you know, if I want to do here, I have to show the time elapsed. I want to show them in hours, such as I want to show 25 hours. Yeah. When I press enter, it will convert. Now, if I want to know the time elapsed, I should go this 3730 format. We have different formats for that. Here we have format for AM PM for 12 hour format, and 13 by 30 is used for 24 hour format. But if you want to go beyond 24 hours, such as you need to know that the how much time elapsed in hours, then you have to go either 30 by 55 or 37 by 30 format. So here is the actual format to show that.
What purpose this is for the 30, 55, 33, that is the time lapsing we can able to see, or
such as you have installed a biometric system in your company. What it will show? It will show you the time stamp, such as a man enters in today's date and leaves your office after 2 days, or you are owner of a hotel and a guest comes in night time at a specific time and leaves your guest house after 2-3 days. Then if you need to know that how much hour he had spent in your hotel, then it will be quite useful. How we will calculate that, such as I will enter here, yeah, what is the date today? 15th of April 14 at 10 a.m. somebody comes. Okay. And he leaves my guest house after 2 days at 2 p.m. Okay. So it was his in time, it was out time. Now the total hours he spent G2 minus latest time minus earliest time. So it is showing me in some numbers. If I convert their format into time and this 37 by 30 format, it will show me the actual hours. Okay. And some of the laborers are working in your, some of the blue collar workers are working in your company, and they, you have to give overtime to them. Then you have to calculate that hours after 8 hours. So how will you evaluate them by their entry? If you want to create a systematic process for that, So you will attach this system to the biometric system, and by his in time and out time, you can calculate his overtime. Correct, sir?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
It is somehow somewhere confusing because I am using date time with too much complexity. Firstly,
no, it's fine. Yeah, I understood what is needed. Yeah.
Okay. You have seen sometime that I put here some date.
Okay.
But if you convert in general format, what is that? Have you seen these numbers? What is that?
Yeah. So normally we used to convert it to the date format actually when.
But you know what is the meaning of these numbers?
I think it is calculated from 1902 as of today, the number of days or something.
Correct, sir. Sir. It is correct.
Yeah.
We have a date, a function called now, which returns us date and time. If you convert it to general format, you will find for date, it is showing these values,
the time also, okay.
The positive ones, and after decimal, it denotes the time. So, if I put here today and if I minus the values from today and convert the format as time in AMPM format, I will get to know the current time. So, we should know about these things for playing with date and time. Now you got to know the time in 12-hour format and 24-hour format and beyond 24-hour format.
Yeah.
Now let's go with percentage. I think you must maybe familiar of that. Yes.
Yeah, percentages are used.
If I put 1 and convert it to percentage, it is going to show me 100%, and 2
yeah.
is 200%. But if the format is applied, then if I type 10, then it will be 10% only, means
yeah.
I convert in number format, so it will show me 0.10. For converting instantly the format of all of them, I am using Control Shift button. How I am converting that? If I press Control Shift first button to 1, it is tilde. It is called tilde. So it converts in general format. I'll show you where it is. This button. So
okay.
Press with Control Shift.
Control Shift tilde. Okay.
Control Shift tilde. It will show you in general format. Control Shift 1. It will show you in number format. Control Shift 2. It will show you in time format. Control Shift 3 for date. Control Shift 4 for currency. Control Shift 5 for percentage. And Control Shift 6 for exponential values, but it would be no, it would not be required to you exponential. So these are some easy shortcuts for playing with these formats. Now let's move to other. Yes.
Can you give me a break? Yes,
you may take. Okay, sir.
No. Once I will come back, I will give a this call to you, so we will start.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Is it okay, sir?
No problem, sir. No problem.
Thursday, I have this issue actually. Next after that you won't get this.
No problem, sir. I have also an issue. No, I will tell you after.
Okay, sir, no problem.
Okay. So we were learning about these fractions, after percentage, fractions. Fractional numbers you can create from here. Suppose if you want to show 1.5 as 1 and 1 by 2, so you can use this fractional number format. There are different sub formats you can choose. But we don't use it too much. In scientific we don't use so much things because it is not of our concern. Text, we use sometime text, such as we are entering some check numbers. It should be of 6 digits. So for putting 6 digits, one way, if I have to add 0 before my text, then I have to put this quotation mark, single quotation mark, and then I put my numbers. This is one way for doing that. And the other way for doing the same, you just select the area where you are putting your value and select the number format as text. Now whatever you will type, so you need not to put any quotation mark there. You can directly put your values starting with 0. If you put formula here, it will not work here. It will not calculate because it also has been taken as text. So if this problem occurs, convert it to general format and press F2 and then enter. Then only it will calculate your value.
Can you tell me, sir, once again, the general format?
Yes, general format. Just convert as general format.
Okay.
In numbers, select general, this much only. Then.
Okay, convert to general format, it will work. Okay.
Yes, double click on that and then enter. Then only it will work. Okay. So there are some special formats, but the working of a special format we usually do with custom formatting. So question starts from here, that suppose I had entered some check numbers here, I'm working here, but accidentally I convert to number. Then how will I again put the zeros there? Do you have any idea about that?
No. Normally once we converted, then we don't want to, actually when we are downloading data from different places, normally it is come as a text. Then we will just convert it to the numbers and we will start working on that. So we never go back to the original state.
So if you want that, then only custom formatting will work. Here what you have seen, it was the pre-formats have been given to you. But in custom format, we can create our own format. So let's start with, we know the say check numbers are of 6 digit, we will put 6 times 0 here. Okay. Now if you put anything, it will add zeros automatically. But what is the difference between earlier value and now value? I can calculate them as well.
Yeah, earlier value is more like text. This is a number.
Yes, I can calculate the these values. So we will be knowing more in our next class about custom formatting, because it is a long topic.
Okay.
And we will let you know that how to use these signs, how to understand these signs and how to work with them. Okay, sir. So today's session is complete now. Okay. The recording you will find in same folder. Okay, sir. Good night.